All right, let's get into our first big story. The sudden decision by the Independent National Electoral Commission to conclude the rerun election in Rivers State is generating mixed reactions.
INEC decided on the date after a threat issued last Thursday by the Senate to suspend plenary if the poll is not conducted on or before December the 10th. But some stakeholders, including some members of the political parties, say this news should not yet be celebrated.
Well, TVC News' Uche Okoro has reports on that.
After a long period of uncertainty, INEC has finally announced December the 10th as date for the outstanding and conclusive election in Rivers State. For the Labour Party in the state, though the long suspense was unnecessary, the announcement is a welcome development. But the Rivers State chairman of the Labour Party is worried that this might not just be the last attempt by INEC to conclude the election.
There are a lot of processes to an election, and when we begin to see those processes, we will know that INEC are serious. But for now, INEC is not yet serious. They are just saying it may be because they are forced by National Assembly to do that. They want to just play to the gallery for people to push the blame. But for now, until we see the processes, I can't believe that INEC is prepared to hold the election.
Isaac Nwomo is the Labour Party candidate aspiring to represent Ikwerre Emoha federal constituency at the National Assembly. He says INEC is yet to address any of his party's concerns because there still exists the possibility of other political parties to benefit from electoral violence.
There have been quite some litigations by various political parties against INEC, and INEC need to also dispense with those matters in court. Except we also hope that National Assembly and otherwise should be able to call the parties already in court to be able to withdraw their matters for election to hold.
One will also warn that INEC might still be faced with legal obstacles that are capable of obstructing the conduct of the poll.
I don't think INEC has solutions considering the level of violence and corruption in River State electoral processes. I don't think INEC has that credibility and has the necessary know-how to be able to enforce the rules in ensuring for good electoral processes. But we in Labour Party, we just left to our fate.
Meanwhile, the number of groups threatening to embark on protests if INEC still fails to conduct the election as it has before now is rising by the day. The elections are expected to hold to elect some lawmakers into the state and national assemblies. Uche Okoro, TVC News, Port Harcourt.
All right, that's the background to the story. We look forward to how things are going to play out in the coming days. Joining us now is a social commentator, Chinedu Nwoye Glamo. It's good to have you join us right now.
Morning.
You're welcome.
Good morning.
You look glamorous.
And of course, from our Port Harcourt studio is a public affairs analyst, Andrew Ajayi. Good morning, and thanks for joining us.
Good morning. Good morning.
All right. This, election, how do we describe it now? It had to take the members of the National Assembly, the Senate specifically, to remind INEC about the rerun election, that's supposed to have taken place in Rivers. Some have described it as the forgotten election. Mike, let me start with you right here in the studio.
Yeah, Chinedu.
What's your thought on this?
Rivers State rerun, I want us to understand that INEC is not the only stakeholder in Rivers State's election. Mm-hmm. So INEC alone cannot determine the successfulness of the election. People in River State are so desperate about getting into positions. The people of River State should be advised whether they like it or not. Yes, Onwike has become the governor. Rotimi Amaechi has become a minister. Many people have died from the youths and the poor people. Dakuku Peter Side is the DG of National Marita. So people should stop staking their lives for other people.
The desperation is much. All right, Chinedu, we'll come back to this shortly after this. Let's go on a break and then we'll come back on the program. Stay with us. All right, if you're just joining us, you're watching TVC Breakfast. And on this segment, we are discussing the rerun elections scheduled in Rivers State in the southern part of Nigeria. And we have in the studio Chinedu Nwoye joining us in here. And from our Port Harcourt studio, we have Andrew Ajayi joining us. Now, before we went on break, you were giving us the foundation as to the complication in
the desperation in Rivers State is much. It's much. It has affected so many things. Even for the Senate to tell INEC they must conduct it on or before the 10th of December, INEC is not the only stakeholder that considers the successfulness of any election. We have the politicians. If they are so desperate, they will make the environment volatile for the INEC. They will not conduct the election. We have the so many other stakeholders who have security outfits that determines the successfulness and security of the election. So all those other stakeholders should also be given that mandate from the Senate. Another thing I want to advise the people of Rivers State is that they are the ones that are being marginalized. They are the ones that are being disenfranchised. Because for some time now, over 6 months, they've not been represented in the Senate and even in their State House of Assembly, in the Federal House of Representatives. So they should get their ass in order and make sure their place is fully represented. So many of them have been, so many good things have eluded them. Some of them should have been appointed as SAs or PAs to all these senators. Yeah. So they are losing a lot. Their voices are not heard in the National Assembly. So they need to put their house in order for the election to be held.
All right, let's get to, let's get to Andrew in our Port Harcourt studio. Andrew, you are there on ground. Give us a perspective or an idea. What are the factors that are really complicating the election in Rivers State?
Well, thank you very much. I think that for me, I'm not really seeing anything that is actually complicating the rerun elections here in Rivers State, except some individual calculations that we can do, which may be right or wrong. But I think the complications that we have, from my own perspective, is the fact that the body language of INEC, stemming from the national even to the states, is such that I think they are in some kind of web, cobweb, entangled in some cobweb, that they cannot even really know what to do. Such that they are either thinking, if I dance to, you know, the body language of the ruling party, especially when it looks as if we just got out from an administration who was in control for 16 years. So for me, that is actually the thing that I am seeing. And it is right or wrong if that is actually what is making INEC to be in this type of web that now made them to need the Senate to now be threatening them before they can now say they want to conduct elections December 10th in Rivers State.
Well, I'm wondering,
I think that, basically speaking,
Andrew, I'm wondering what kind of entanglement,
yes,
is, you know, that you mean exactly. Are you saying that INEC really is not as independent as one would have expected the body to be?
Yes, I even said it in your news program some 2 or 3 days ago when I was your guest here. I said it that an institution that says its name is National Independent Electoral Commission or Independent National Electoral Commission, INEC, must be seen to be acting as such. Such that if it is not acting as such to be independent, every Tom, Dick and Harry will speak to it, either positively or negatively. And that was why the Senate started speaking to INEC, threatening them to conduct elections. If not, since 2015, when the elections were conducted, what would we really say is the underlying factor that is making INEC to now become a dog that is castrated, that cannot even do what it's supposed to do that is recognized in the Constitution? Could it be that it is listening to the body language of the ruling party, or it is also afraid of the fact that the PDP people too will also be attacking it? That is actually what I think is the problem. Because if INEC is not entangled in this web, I think the people of Rivers, who yearn to see their senators in the red chambers and their House of Representative members complete in the Green Chambers, of course, by now would have been done with all the electoral processes that will galvanize or bring into existence the senators and the House of Representative members. So I think that we should copy from the American experience that is going on today, because by tomorrow America will be conducting election to show to the world that they are the world and best democracy in the world. Okay. And if we as a people, Nigeria, we are copying from the American nation, we must do what America is doing that is making them to be the best democracy in the world. So INEC must wake up from the slumber that it currently is now to actually do what it's supposed to do.
Okay, Andrew.
INEC should pack up.
All right, Andrew, it's still part of the analysis we're talking about. Everyone is watching the American election. But however, let me come back to you, Chinedu. Now, it took the Senate to say if you don't conduct election by the on or before the 10th of December, we're going to do this or we're going to do that. For INEC to wake up and say, okay, we're fixing a date for the election. If we have to deduce from what Andrew just said, do you think INEC on its own has what it takes when it comes to credibility to conduct this election?
Yes. To an extent, it lies on INEC to conduct a credible election. But as I said earlier, that they are just 50% stakeholder in the successfulness of election. Mm. So other stakeholders, most importantly, the people of River State. Last night I was watching the news, the governor of River State said he saw people, or they caught some people with a fake result sheet and all that. River State has turned to be a political war ground. Any movement made in River State is being suspected to be this or that, and is not helping the ground. So it's raising dust all the time. It's creating dangers all the time. So the people of River State have about 50% participation in getting the election to be done. For Senate to even say they will go on strike is not in order. Yes, Senate is not supposed to go on strike.
Yeah, but if the results are there already.
Exactly. Yes.
If that is what it takes to bring INEC to wake up to its responsibility.
The people I expect to come and protest, the people, the constituency, the people that are being marginalized. For Senate to come and start saying it is like being influenced. I want to see the people of Rivers come out and say, we want this.
But don't you think the people of Rivers themselves are actually war weary? I mean, this protracted elections, you know, rerun of a rerun.
Exactly.
And another rerun.
Another rerun.
Shouldn't the people already be tired?
And it's still caused by their body languages.
Really?
Yes.
How?
Any movement made by APC is being suspected by PDP. Any movement made by PDP is being suspected by the APC.
Which is normal in an election situation.
Normal,
anyway.
But there's no trust anymore.
Yes.
There's no trust in River State. If former governor Rotimi Amaechi comes into River State, everybody will be, what did he come to do? You see the movement, you see the body language. If the present governor goes out to visit somebody, why did he visit this person? So they have caused so much problem. The only thing is that the people of River State are being marginalized by this. For over 6 months, they've not been represented, not only in the federal house, even in their own state assembly. You see, if only they can come together to know that at the end, River State is losing. At the end, the poor masses in the River State are the ones losing out.
Okay, let me bring Andrew in here. Andrew, tell us, what is really at stake in this election? Chinedu just said here that every move made by either the governor or even the minister of transport when he gets back home is suspect. And you know, so what is really at stake in this election in River State?
Well, thank you very much. Let me quickly say that while what my guest there in your studio said is true, I want to say that there is something that is fundamentally wrong with the type of electoral democratic election process that we are actually practicing, in the sense that not until we start giving ourselves the right political education of the understanding of democracy, so that at the end of the day, the people's attitude will be greatly of reformation in character, okay, then we will not be able to do anything. Because majority of the people who are in politics today, in our society. They want to do everything either by hook or crook, throwing up all necessary tantrums to blackmail, to denigrate even the opposing or opposition, as the case may be. And if we continue like this without the right political enlightenment and education in our society, the Nigerian citizen, who is supposed to be the beneficiary of democratic processes where commonwealth resources are supposed to be used to bring about great infrastructure and other development in terms of education and good health, will continue to suffer. Now, let me tell you that what is at stake as far as this rerun election is concerned and in Rivers State is between the APC and the PDP. The battle for supremacy, the battle of ego, the battle of, let me even use local palace that are the one here now. In fact, it will never succeed. And they will continue to, deal with themselves. And
unfortunately,
let me be very honest with you.
No, but we can hear his voice.
Okay,
anyway.
Well, we can.
Go ahead, Andrew. We can hear you.
Go ahead.
And unfortunately, it is going to be a situation whereby if we do not curb all this attitude of the politicians, because they see politics as do or die. Ordinarily, I do not think that the American society see politics as a do or die. That is why they will go to election tomorrow. They have been doing it for over 1 year. They have been campaigning. And we have seen what the two candidates want to offer to the American people.
All so right,
if
Andrew,
truly
all right.
To be a democracy,
all right, just hold on.
People,
yes.
Just hold on.
We lost the visual signal there, but we could still hear his voice.
We'll quickly take a commercial break. And when we return,
we'll go on with the program, but certainly at that time we'll be going out on TVC Entertainment, and viewers there can cross over to TVC News on Concert. We're on Concert Channel 190 and DSTV Channel 418.
And GoTV 45, of course, ACTV 510. Yeah. Stay there. Right, yo, welcome back. You're watching TVC Breakfast and we're looking at the Rivers rerun election. Yes, a date has been set now thanks to the Senate that actually threatened the INEC. Of course, the Independent National Electoral
Commission.
And they
got the result.
And they got the result. Well, that's what's important at the end of the day. We have Chinedu Moye Glamour, our guest in the studio. And in Port Harcourt there, Andrew Ajayi is, of course, there to make contributions on this issue. Now, what really are the likely implications? Because it looks like all the parties involved, the APC, the PDP, even the Labour Party representative that we spoke with in that report, nobody seems to have confidence that INEC will deliver at the end of the day, come December 10. What does this mean for Rivers State?
All right.
Andrew.
Well, as I was saying before, you see, the implications are very numerous and grievous as well. One of the implications is that INEC, the confidence and integrity that the Nigerian people has or should have for INEC will perpetually continue to be in depletion, and which is very, very sad. And on the part of political parties, let me be very honest with you, the two political parties that are actually competing to win these various seats in the Senate or House of Assembly, National Assembly rerun election in Rivers State, is APC and PDP. We don't even know the rest. So what I want to say categorically here is that there are certain things INEC must do, okay, to you know, increase that depleting or declining confidence that people of society and River State in particular has in INEC, is for them to actually go back to the Electoral Act, go back to the Nigerian Constitution, look at the aims and objective that the nation needed to have been able to establish INEC. And the practitioners in INEC, the operators of INEC, will begin to ask themselves some thought-provoking questions to say, since we were established as INEC, vis-a-vis the vision, the goals of this establishment, have we been able to satisfy the people of Nigeria? If they are able to answer these questions themselves without bias, if they have not played any wuru-wuru or magomago or danced towards any political party in terms of them receiving money and now giving them a result sheet to write election result where a winner did not win, you say the person is the one who won, thereby causing confusion, making the whole process to now go to court and tribunal. If they are able to ask themselves this question, I want to tell you that the implications that we will now be having about INEC activities will be positive implications.
All right, Andrew, thank you. We'll come back to you on this. Now, Chinedu, there was an election. At the time of election, there was a report some persons died. During the rerun, the first rerun, some persons died. At the second rerun, some persons died. But in all of this, people in River States, they are watching from whichever side they support, as the case may be. But how would this lead to an apathy in the coming election that is fixed for 10th of December?
Yes, people will continue to die if River States have refused to learn their lessons. I blame the youth, those they use for this thuggery. I blame them because those that are bringing you out are not sending their children or their nephews and cousins to lead the thuggery. You see, if only we learn, some youths will come out with placards. They will carry placards. When you remove the placards and ask the person carrying the placards, what is the cause you are propagating with this placard? He will not tell you. He doesn't know. Because he's just being programmed there by the director of the film to play this. You understand? So some of the youths, they don't know what they are carrying. They don't know what they are doing. People are using you to get to places. And I've told them severally that whether you like it or not, the Nyesom Wike has become a governor of River State. Honorable Rotimi Amaechi is now the minister of transport. Dakuku side, Peter side, is now the DG of National Maritime. So what are these people now? Some of them are in the grave. You see, some of them are in the hospital because they placed you there to cause confusion. So I don't see apathy because River States, they are so, I don't know how to put it for me not to be misunderstood. But the issue there is that only when they understand that this is representing the people,
it's really all about them.
It's all about that. If the people want the person in APC, let the person go. If the people want that person go. If the people want, that's where INEC comes. That's why I'm supporting my friend in Port Harcourt. I say, if only INEC would not dance to any side, no matter the pressure. Definitely there will be pressure on INEC. I know they are human beings, they're not from heaven. They are from this country, Nigeria.
And of course, in the midst of all of this, INEC's preparedness is also in question.
Yes, but the pressure coming on them makes them to at times deviate. You see, trying to support the power that be at the center or trying to play with the... And they are watching, even the Commissioner of Police in River State, everybody is watching him to know where he will sign.
Let me remind you of something, a statement Wike made just a couple of days ago to both of you gentlemen. He said, judges have lost their voice and politicians are now happy. Quoting Wike, I'm just wondering what the implication,
what exactly he means
by this statement. Do you want to respond to that?
Because
Andrew said something about, you know, eventually this, you know, the case might just end up in court and all of that. Now the judges have this big cloud of, you know, integrity or otherwise.
Integrity test.
Some judges were arrested. Not all the judges were arrested. And even some lawyers do complain of corrupt judges. There's one thing about this country, Nigeria. Anything you do, some opposition, there's one thing I want us to understand. Some oppositions are not supporting the goodness of the masses. They are planning for the next election. If you want to borrow money, and they know that when you borrow this money, you do infrastructure that will make people to vote you by 2019, they will stop the loan in order not for you, they will frustrate it in order not for you to borrow and do a good thing for the masses to vote for you. So politicians, I don't trust them. I'm telling you the truth, because at times the way they will pursue a cause, you think they have your interest, they have their personal interest. They plan 2019 more than they plan governance. Some of them have stopped anything governance. They are planning how the election will be. So if the governor in that particular state is to do road construction, they may go as far as finding a way to frustrate that road construction so that the people in that area will not benefit. So that at the end, they will use it against you that you promised you would do this road. Now you did not do it.
All right. Andrew, let me ask you this. You are on ground there. You've been following all of this developments in River State. Now, there was a statement Chinedu made here. He didn't complete, but let me deduce this meaning out of what he was trying to say that River State people are very... He didn't finish it, but let me add something to it. River State people are very enlightened when it comes to knowing what the laws are, when it comes to people who are far and widely traveled, and they know what elections are. They know what the implication of all of these things are.
And they know what they want.
And they know what they want. And that's where we see all this tension in there. But how come all of this knowledge, all this wealth of experience and knowledge and exposure has not been able to translate into a civic commitment to the system?
Thank you. Let me be very honest with you. Although I would have loved to actually speak on the issue of security you asked, although I will allude to that as I move on. Let me be very honest with you. You see, you cannot give what you don't have. Nemo dat quod non habet. So if you are saying that Rivers people are very knowledgeable people and that they are not able to translate it, then I want to say that that is not knowledge. A knowledge that you have that you cannot translate into practicalities to bring about greatest benefit to the greatest happiness of your people, I mean, then what do we say about that? So what I think is that earlier I had said that we need a lot of political enlightenment, political education that will translate into attitudinal change. Because as far as this place is concerned, River State, and by extension the whole country, we want to see politics and electioneering process as a do or die. And that is like an act of corruption that is already endemic in our blood vessel that may actually be very, very difficult to move out. But through the right public enlightenment and education, the people will now begin to know what they are doing. So that when it comes to election, as is happening in US now, I want to ask the people listening, how many stories of death, shooting, and of gun trotting that you have heard that they said Hillary Clinton gave to the members of Democrats, or that Donald Trump gave to the members of Republicans? But in our country here and in our state here, that is what we see politicians do. So that at the end of the day, politics, democracy, and election is in fact, as security is being negotiated, and a lot of money goes into it. Some youth cultists are recruited, young people are recruited, guns are given to them to go and threaten people in the various polling units. Is that the type of election we will want to continue as a people living in a nation and as a people in River State? If you ask me philosophically, I say no, and people must get that type of education. If I were a youth, because I'm above youth now in terms of my age, I would want to tell any politician who want to give me gun, who want to give me ammunition to go and target one person to kill the person, or to go and steal one ballot boxes to say, if your daughter's name is Adama or you are Chukwuneke, can you bring Chukwuneke to come and join me so that we'll go and do the job?
It's a very good question.
But the youth, they are waiting that themselves. When it is time for politics, that politicians will give them plenty money so that they will go and be causing mayhem and all that as their own share of the political process. That is why I have talked about character reformation. We must remove our orientation to come to a reorientation of the fact that politics should not be played the way we are currently playing. Let me conclude, please. Let me quickly say this.
All right.
The issue of security and the politicians. I want to let you know that at times the security agencies of the DSS, of the police, of the army, they are also complacent in all of this electionary process, because at times I have been critical enough to observe some of the election process that are going on. Do you know that?
Okay, Andrew, we'll have to leave it there.
And at the end of the day, in the front of the police, in the front of the army.
Okay,
all right, Andrew,
we'll
thank you very much. You're so passionate about this, and we look forward to the passion from the people translating into
successful
elections.
It is because we want to change this country. Andrew, that is why we are talking the way we are talking.
Thank you very much, Andrew, for giving us your time this morning. Thank you, Andrew.
It's confirmation of what you said initially. It's not only INEC that's a stakeholder in this issue. Okay. I guess this is where we'll have to say thank you to the gentlemen.
Thank you, gentlemen. Thank you for coming.
Andrew Ajayi, thank you so much. Public Affairs Analyst and Chinedu Nwoye Glamour for joining us on the show this morning.
It's always a pleasure being here. God bless you guys.
Thank you.
You too. There's a lot more on TVC Breakfast this morning. Stay with us.